Now question is, a stone is dropped from the top of a tower. So tower height that we have, which is h is equal to 500 meter, into a pond of water at the base of the tower. When is the splash heard at the top, right? So when that object we dropped, and then because of water we heard in the sound will travel in this direction, in upward direction, and then we heard. So g is given, speed of sound that we have, right? So g is equal to 10 meter second to inverse, and speed of sound that we have 340 meter second inverse. So question is, when is this splash heard at the top, right? So after dropping that, when we heard that, so first we need to find time, right? Time to drop that particular stone. So timing, to find that timing, v is equal to actually here, yes, see, we dropped, so initial speed is zero, right? We have 500 meter, so we can finding time with the help of second equation of motion, that is s is equal to ut plus half gt square. So s is 500 is equal to 0 plus half, we are dropping, that's why we have to take 10 as positive, and t that we don't know, so t square, so 2 5s are 500 by 500, so t square is equal to 100. So then t is equal to 10 second. So for dropping that stone, it will take 10 second to be in the water. Now after splash, when sound is coming in upper direction, right, that time we need to find. So again, v is equal to distance upon time. Time we have to subject, so h upon v. What is h? 500 upon v is 340, right? 0 0 gets cancelled out, so 50 upon 34, it is 1.22 something approximately, so 1.22 second. So total time after dropping that stone will be t dash is equal to 10 plus 1.22, means 11.22 second is the total time that takes to hear here that splash, because when stone is dropped it will take 10 second, and then sound is coming in upward direction, it will take 1.22. So total timing is 11.22.